Here we have our 3D physically based artificial intelligent whales. They have a full vision system that uses a neural net, which is an artificial intelligent, artificial brain technique, where their sight moves in and creates a neural net which affects their speed and pitch. In general, they have a full artificial intelligent brain. We saw the low-level system, which is based on vision and obstacle avoidance. But obviously, some of those obstacles are things like their mother or the Exxon Valdez. In that case, it's an object recognition through its that goes to its internal state in terms of its memory and its drives of eating and other drives and behaviors are picked in an action selection system. I'll bring up that system now live on the computer. So here we see the different whales that I can see here. This is the male. This is the baby following its mother. And this is another female. I can move up and see the top of the water. And then down again. This is in our full rendering. We don't have all the underwater effects we could have. The females tend to stay near this object. We call it the God object. As you can see, they can play with this ball, which is just temporary at the moment. But I can move it towards me as well, too, and they'll follow. You can see it bounces off of them. And they swim naturally. And I could grab any one of them, which I'll try and do now. And this is actually the mechanics of a particular whale. So here is its eyesight. So if I turned it off, and pull back, I see that I have this whale right here. I'll start it again. And it'll start moving again. And I'll turn off it on its sensors, which is its eyesight, and the forces that affect it, which is the red. Move this a little bit closer. As it swims towards it, I'll stop again. So there I just turned it into a... I just turned its brain off. I'll move the ball away as you see the others playing with it. I'll stop this for sure, so I'm going to bring this in. I'll hit the stop button. You see it just went to rest now. And I could do forward or reverse or paddle on one side or pitch up. Or pitch down. I can also affect, I can open and close the mouth, or move the head back and forth. So these are the controls that I have that affect the AI. So it's these kind of genes that get put together in more complicated ways to control the artificial intelligence. With this then, I'll turn it back on again so it can move with the characters. With this type of system, then, I'm able to create artificial intelligent characters that behave on their own. And this is these are beginning to start showing up in game systems. Again, I have its vision on, and you can see with the red parts how it can see other characters around and move accordingly. Artificial intelligent whales. They have a full vision system. That uses a neural net, which is an artificial intelligent, artificial brain technique, where their sight moves in and creates a neural net which affects their speed and pitch. In general, they have a full artificial intelligent brain. We saw the low-level system, which is based on vision and obstacle avoidance. But obviously, some of those obstacles are things like their mother or the Exxon Valdez. In that case, it's an object recognition through its that goes to its internal state in terms of its memory and its drives of eating and other drives and behaviors are picked in an action selection system. I'll bring up that system now live on the computer. So here we see the different whales that I can see here. This is the male. This is the baby following its mother. And this is another female. I can move up and see the top of the water. And then down again. This isn't our full rendering. We don't have all the underwater effects we could have. The females tend to stay near this object. We call it the God object. As you can see, they can play with this ball, which is just temporary at the moment. But I can move it towards me as well, too, and they'll follow. And you can see it bounces off of them. And they swim naturally. And I could grab any one of them, which I'll try and do now. And this is actually the mechanics of a particular whale. So here is its eyesight. So if I turned it off, pull back. I see that I have this whale right here. I'll start it again. And it'll start moving again. And I'll turn off its own sensors, which is its eyesight, and the forces that affect it, which is the red. Move this a little bit closer. As it swims towards it, I'll stop again. So there, I just turned its brain off. I'll move the ball away as you see the others playing with it. The ball. And I'll stop this for sure. So I'm going to bring this in. I'll hit the stop button. You see it just went to rest now. And I could do forward or reverse or paddle on one side or pitch up. Or pitch down. I can also affect, I can open and close the mouth or move the head back and forth. So these are the controls that I have that affect the AI. So it's these kind of genes that get put together in more complicated ways to control the artificial intelligence. With this, then, I'll turn it back on again so it can move with the characters. With this type of system, then, I'm able to create artificial intelligent characters that behave on their own. And these are beginning to start showing up in game systems. Again, I have its vision on, and you can see with the red parts how it can see other characters around and move accordingly.